about everywhere that you can imagine. I mean, the ones that get the most publicity are hotels and apartment buildings and single-family homes. But we encounter bed bugs in restaurants, office buildings, of course, hotels, fire departments, retail stores, libraries, college dormitories, banks, funeral homes, daycare centers, schools. In other words, just about anywhere where there are people that can transport these bugs in, we can have bed bugs. There have been reports we've had bed bugs in movie theaters. When I say we, I'm talking about the United States, not necessarily Lexington or Louisville, but like any city, we're vulnerable to these types of problems.
How are they getting to these places? For example, somebody's office. How is that happening?
Well, they get transported in on belongings. In other words, this is not like an ant or a spider that, you know, crawls in from outdoors. They have to be carried in, transported in on personal belongings. So, you know, someone has bed bugs at home and they get into a purse or a backpack or a briefcase and in they come. And they crawl out and they become established in these places that don't typically have, you know, a bed or people sleeping. So they just get carried in on things.
And daycares, places like that, what's happening with that?
Well, again, I mean, across the United States, we're finding bed bugs in schools and daycares. And again, they get brought in on the kids' stuff. So it's, and the thing that is so, I guess, disturbing or predictable about this is history has given us the absolute roadmap for all the places that we're finding bed bugs again today. Because this was, you know, years ago when they would talk about boarding houses and hospitals almost in the same sentence in terms of places you would find bed bugs. The laundromat, movie theaters, on the subway systems and the buses and the taxi cabs. And you know, there was a survey done in the 1930s in Sweden. They inspected 3,000 moving vans. They found bed bugs on 47% of them. So none of this should come as a surprise to us this second time around, you know, with this bed bug, you know, resurgence.
Where do they live once they're inside, for example, your home, your apartment?
Well, they want to be as close. Oh, we're not recording right now, are we?
Yes, we are.
We are, okay. Sorry. They want to be close to the sleeping person, you know, the food, the meal. I mean, why crawl 20 feet to your next meal if you can crawl 6 inches? So the first place we find bed bugs is close to the bed or where the people sleep. Sometimes if they sleep on couches or recliners, we find them there. So the mattress, the box spring, the frame of the bed, a headboard, if there is a headboard, is probably number one, followed by...
It came back to life.
It's come back to life. It's the Verizon place.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
So,
you were answering about where the bed bugs are.
They live.
Yeah, so you know, the couches and recliners and so forth. But with time, as the infestations get worse, they start to move outward from these sleeping areas, and that's where it gets very difficult to control them because they can be almost anywhere. I mean, behind pictures, along the edges of the carpeting, inside, you know, appliances, inside the bindings of books. I mean, you name it, they can you know, get there. So one of the key things about dealing with bed bugs is trying to catch these problems early on before they've spread into all the other stuff, because that's when it gets really difficult to control them.
We actually went with a person who was treating it in a house. This guy was kind of senile. And so he agreed to have us film, but he didn't really talk to us. Basically, it wasn't his books on the walls, all over the house.
Yeah.
It was just, awful to watch.
Yeah. I mean, it can break your heart, because particularly people that don't have the resources, you know, to hire a professional and don't have anywhere to turn. One of the most common questions I get asked is, isn't there some agency where they have the resources to fund the eradication of these infestations? And unfortunately, there's not a lot of that. Each city, you know, around the United States, there are things that are being done, task forces being appointed, and legislation developed in terms of whose responsibilities it is to get rid of the bed bugs. For example, in apartment buildings, largely the responsibility is on the landlord to eradicate these infestations, even though the landlord didn't start this problem. You have to feel for them because these bugs were transported in by the tenants. Not necessarily that tenant, it could have been a previous tenant or they could have moved in that building. But, you know, there's a lot of finger pointing going on in terms of who's responsible for these problems and who's responsible to get rid of the infestations. And then they say, well, the pest control companies are so expensive. Well, it's very tedious and time consuming to eradicate these things. So the pest control companies, you know, that's why they charge a lot of money to get rid of bed bugs. Unfortunately, I mean, there's a lot of critters that I can tell a householder how to get rid of their cockroaches or how to get rid of their ants. Bed bugs is one that's very tough to get rid of yourself. It's much more involved than just going to the hardware store and getting a can of bug spray and spraying your bed. So it's really tough.